Welcome back, friends. In this class, we are going to cover Java array variable and the for each loop. Okay. Now we are going to see what is Java array variable, how to use Java array variable. Okay. Using array variable, we can store same type of multiple values. Using array variable, we can store same type of multiple values. In generally, if you declare any variable like this, int a equal to 20, 10. If you say like this, what is the meaning of this line of program? I have declared one variable called a, its type is integer. In that variable, I stored one value called 10. That's it, right? If you want to store multiple value in this a variable, what we need to do, we need to create an array variable. If you want to create array variable, we have to follow this syntax. Okay, int a, open the bracket, close the bracket. If you say like this, this a variable is a array variable, this area a variable is array variable. In this a variable, we can store more than one integer value. Okay, this is the syntax of declaring array variable. Okay, data type, then variable, followed by open the bracket and close the bracket. Okay, now here I want to assign some multiple values. Okay, if you say like this, int a equal to new int of 3. If you say like this, I have declared array variable a, then I am initializing, I am allocating size of the array variable. I am saying how many value I can store inside the array variable a. Through this syntax, I am saying how many value I can store inside a array variable a. Using new operator, I am allocating size of my array variable. New int of 3, meaning in this a variable I can store three different integer value. We cannot store different type of value. That meaning in this a variable I cannot store string value, I cannot store char value, I can store only integer value. Three different integer value I can store. Okay, this is the one of the way of declaring and initializing array variable. Okay, now I want to assign some value. To array variable a. According to this line, I declared and initialized. I have defined here how many value I can store in this a variable. I am saying three variable I can store in this a variable, a array variable. Now I want to assign that three value inside the array value, array variable. Okay. Whenever you define like this, what will happen? Java allocate the memory for this array variable like this. Java allocate the memory for array variable like this. One, two, three. So here you can see three rooms. You can see three rooms. Okay. Each room we can store one value for that array variable. If you want to refer each room, we need to use index value. Whenever you create an array variable, Java create an index of each room. For example, here the first room index is 0, second room index is 1, third room index is 2. Okay. Whenever you create an array variable, Java allocate the memory like this, okay, with a different room. each room having a unique index value. That index value always start from zero. Index value always start from zero. Okay, here I have initialized the array variable for tree. So the index value start with zero. The first value I can store in 0th index. Second value I can store in 1st index. Third value I can store in 2nd index. Now how to assign value in this index? Okay. If you want to refer 0th index, we have to say like this. A, open the bracket, then which index you want to refer? I want to refer 0th index, then close the bracket, equal to 100. If you say like this, I am assigning 100 value to 0th index of in my array variable. 0th index of in my array variable. That meaning the 0 value will store here. The 100 value store in 0th position of in my array variable. 0th position in my array variable. Now if you say like this, A of 1 equal to 200. What will happen? A of 1, what is A of 1? 0, 1. This is the A of 1. Okay, so here 200 will store. If you say like this, A of 2 equal to 300. So the 300 value stored in 2nd index. Where is the 2nd index here? This is the 2nd index. 2nd index 300. So through we can assign some value to each index position of in your array variable. Okay, index value always start with 0. According to our program here, we have initialized array variable to 3, so 3 value I can store. So first value always start with 0th index, so 0th index I am storing 100. Second value always start with 1, so I am storing 200. Third value is a second index, right? In the second position I am storing 300. Okay, 0 meaning first value, 1 meaning second value, second index meaning here third value. Okay, this is index. Okay, this is index value. Index value of array. Then this is actual value stored in array. This is okay. I hope you understand the concept of array variable. Okay. Now we'll go into see the same example in the first program. I have a program already here. Let's see that. See, here I declared a variable as a B, right? Here I explained with the variable A. So let me change that variable to A. Now int a equal to new int of 3. I am initializing array variable with a size of 3. So 3 value I can store inside array variable. The first value always store with 0th index. So a of 0 I am saying will follow the same example. A of 0 I am saying here 100, right? So I am assigning here 100. So a of 1 I am saying 200, so I am assigning here 200. So A of 2 I am saying 300, so I am assigning here 300. So now this array variable A having 3 different value in each index. In 0th index, you have 100, 1th index, you have 200, 2nd index, you have 300. Then system.out.println, I want to print this value. Whatever value stored in array variable A, I want to print all the values. For that, I am writing some program here. See that system.out.println 0th index value. These are just a string value I am printing. 0th index value plus A of 0. In A of 0, what is the value assigned? A of 0, I am assigning 100, right? So here, it will print 100 value. It will print 100. Okay, 100 value will print. Then, A of 1. What is A of 1 here? A of 1, I am assigning 200, right? So here, 200 will print. Then, A of 2, I am saying here. Second index value, A of 2. What is A of 2 here? 300, right? So 300 will print. Okay, let's compile this program now. Array Java. Java array demo. See, 0th index 100, 1th index value 200, 2nd index value 300. Whatever value assigned here, that same value printing here. So this is the one of the way of declaring array, initializing array, and printing the array variable values. Okay. The next example we'll going to see different way of initializing the value to the array variable, and we'll going to print array variable values in different ways. Okay, let me open the program 2, array demo program 2. Let me remove everything here. I don't want to use this. Okay, so here I am declaring one array variable called B. Then I am saying equal to open the braces 200, 300, 400, 500. So I am assigning 4 value to B variable. If you want to assign multiple value to B variable, we need to use this syntax equal to array variable equal to B, open the braces and close the braces. Inside the braces, we can pass multiple values with comma separated, with this comma separated. So each value automatically stored in particular index. Here 200 is a very first value, right? So this first value is stored in 0th index. 300 is the second value, right? The second value is stored in first index. Then 400 is the third value. Third value is stored in second index. 500 is the fourth value. The fourth value is stored in third index. Okay. So here I used to print like this, right? A of 0, something like that. So if you want to print all the value in different way, we can use for loop. Using for loop, we can manipulate arrays very effectively. Using not a for loop, generally using loops, we can manipulate the array variables very effectively. Now I want to print whatever value stored in B array variable. I want to print those values using for loop. Now we'll going to see that example now. Okay, I'll go to, before that, I want to show one more thing into size. Array size equal to B dot length. So what is length here? Whenever you create an array variable in Java program, Java provides one property to the array variable. That property always holds, always store what is the size of the particular array variable. What is the size here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 4 different value are stored inside a B variable, right? That meaning size of this array variable is a 4. How many value we are stored inside array variable, that total length is a size. Okay, here 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 different values stored inside a B variable. whenever you say b dot length, that length property return value called Fourier. If you say like this, the length property return value called Trier. Okay, according to the number of value, the size will be returned. Okay, then here I'll go to print system dot out dot println, then length of array variable b is b is array dot size, I am saying. Now whenever say b dot length, this return length of this array variable, current length is 4, right? The 4 value assigned to my array size variable. Here I declared one variable array size, integer type. Now in this array size variable, the length value, this length attribute, right, the length property return a length of the array variable. That here according to this program is written 4, right? That 4 assigned to array dot array size. Now I am printing that array size here. Here we will print 4. So length return length of the array variable, that length value I am storing here. This array size having length value, that array size variable printing here. Now this array size return value called 4. Let me compile this program first. Array demo 2. Array demo 2. See, length of array variable is 4 is printing here because I have 4 different element, right? That is the reason the length property return 4, that 4 assigned to array size variable. That array size variable is printing here. So it's returning 4. It's printing 4. Okay. The next step is I want to print array variable values using for loop. That will go into 0. For you, I hope you are familiar with the for loop. Otherwise, please check my tutorial of what is a for loop. Okay. I have given the video link in the description. Int I equal to 0, I lesser than, I am saying array size I plus plus. Okay. Now inside this for loop, I want to print all the array value. System dot out dot println b of i. Let's see what is b of i. Very first time I value is a 0, right? Very first time I value is a 0. Then I am checking I lesser than array size or not. What is array size value? Array size value is a 4, right? Because my array length is a 4. So length return 4 here. So array size is a 4. I current value is a 0, very first time. 0 definitely lesser than array size only because array size is a 4. So condition is satisfied, it come to here. Here I am printing b of i. B of i meaning I am referring b array variable. In that b array variable, I want to print ith position. That is whatever value stored in inside I, that corresponding index value I want to print. Very first time I value is 0, right? So b of 0, meaning of this line is b of 0. So b of 0 will print what? 200. The b of 0 we have 200, right? First position 200, we are having 200. So 200 will print. So whenever this for loop execute, the first iteration I value is a 0. So b of 0 nothing but 200 will print. So after printing, it will go to the updation section of the for loop. Here I am saying I plus plus. That meaning current value of I is 0. So it will increase 1. So that meaning I become 1, right? So now I current value is a 1. And I am checking here I lesser than array size or not. Definitely I lesser than array size because I value is a 1. Array size is a 4. 1 lesser than 4. Condition satisfied. And come to inside a for loop, system dot out dot println b of i, I am saying That meaning current value of I is 1 now. Current value of I is 1. That meaning B of 1. B of 1. B of 1 equal to, what is the B of 1 here? 300. So 300 will print. 300 will print. The second iteration B of I is B of 1. So 300 will print. After printing the 300, it will again go to the update section of the for loop. Now current value of I is 1, right? When I say I plus plus, I become 2, right? I become 2. Okay. Now I is a 2. What is the array size? Array size is a 4. Array size is a 4, right? Because length is a 4. So I current value is a 2. 2 lesser than 4 or not, I am checking. Definitely 2 is lesser than 4. Condition satisfied, come to inside a for loop. Then here I am saying B of I. B of I. I current value is a 2, right? What is that second index value? 400. B of 2 equal to 400 will print. 400 will print here. Okay. So then after printing, it will go to the update section. So current I value is a 2, right? Whenever say I plus plus, I will become 3. Now we are checking. 3 is lesser than array size. Yes, definitely 3 is lesser than array size. Because I is having a 3, array size is a 4. 3 is lesser than 4 only. Condition satisfied, come to inside a for loop. Here, B of I nothing but B of 3. What is B of 3? 3 is referring this index. 0, 1, 2, 3. This index. This index having a value called 500. 500 will print. Okay. Now we'll go to compile this program. Java array demo2. See here I am printing length of the array variable is 4 is printing here. After that 200, 300, 400, 500 is printing. Okay. Whatever value we are expected here, the same value printing here. Okay. I hope you understand about the array variable, how to define array variable, how to initialize the array variable, how to print the array variable value using for loop. Okay. Now this is the here I am printing the array variable using for loop, right? There is another loop called for each. I never explained about that for each. This for each, using for each loop, we can easily print array variable value. Okay. Syntax of for each, for int a, that is type variable, colon, then your array variable. Array variable. This is the syntax of for each. Okay. Then instead of for each, you can write some program. So this is the syntax of for each. Now I want to print this array variable value using for each. Okay, for each loop. For type meaning, what is my array variable type? Integer, right? Integer. So we need to say here int. Then we need to declare one variable name. That can be anything. Now I am going to say x. Then colon. After colon, we need to specify this array variable. B. My array variable is B, right? Just if we need to specify array variable. Then B. Then, now I want to print. What will happen here? It automatically automatically navigate to my array variable. This for loop automatically navigate to array variable. But in the case of for loop, right, we are navigating manually using for loop. We are saying int I equal to 0, I less than array size, then increase I plus plus. Like that, we are manually navigating here, but here not like that. It will happen automatically. Okay. Whenever execute this for loop, what will happen? This for each loop take first value of array variable and assign to x variable. Then it will print. Now I want to print here. Here you don't have to mention B of I, like that you don't have to mention, just you can mention X here. So whenever execute this for each loop, what will happen? It will come to infinite loop. Whatever value available, in that B variable, those values start printing. Okay, very first time this for each loop take 200 value and assign to X variable. The X value will print. Second time, these for loops take 300 value and assign to x, and then x will print 300. In third time, this for each loop take 400 value and assign to x variable, the x value will print 400. And then fourth time, the for each loop take the 500 value and assign to x variable, and they print the x value. Okay. This is the for each loop. You don't have to mention this condition, everything. Just you have to tell variable type, then colon array variable. That's it. Now you're going to see this output now. Okay. See, 200, 300, 400, 500 printing. For differentiate, I will say like this, x equal to. X equal to 200, 300, 400, 500. I hope you understand about array variable and how to use array variable inside a for each loop. Okay, the for each loop is very simple when compared to for loop. Okay, we don't have to mention initialization and the condition and updation. Everything taken care by your for each loop. Okay. In the next class, we'll going to see how to create a user-defined function. What is the meaning of public static void main string args? This topic we'll going to study in the next class. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.